Good morning. Good to have you all here. Very exciting day, another great day to be a Lion at this university. And I can't tell you how proud we are to have you all here today to celebrate a very special day indeed. And as we all know, we are here to celebrate Charles Garvin, the first African-American graduate of our institution. And really is represents someone that represents the spirit of who we are as an institution. And when you think of words that you think of Charles Garvin, you know, in the program we talk about courage, having a spirit, but what an advocate for education, what a pioneer for the institution and for the family, and of course, a father and an uncle, and whoever that may be, a friend. And so this is, again, when people look back at watershed days at our university, days that made a difference, they're gonna talk about when Mayo came here, Professor Mayo came and established the university. And they're gonna talk about when the name was changed from ET to Texas A&M. And they're gonna talk about the beautiful buildings we have on our campus. All those were important days, but this day is none less important than those days and really sets the stage of how the university moves forward. So Janae and Cedric and Pam and Dwight, thank you so much, and friends and family, thank you so much for lending and sharing your dad with us today. So I really appreciate it. So we'll proceed with the program here, and I would love to introduce the daughter of Charles Garvin to say a few words on behalf of the family. And Mrs. Renee Mack, can you please come up and say a few words for us here? Please help me welcome Renee. Oh, Pam's coming up too. Oh, great. Okay. Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. We stand on behalf of the special celebration of our dad being honored today. It's a blessing to have our family, friends, and each of you here to celebrate this historical moment. We thank God for Texas A&M Commerce, President Rudin, Darrell Peace, and all parties involved in recognizing and honoring our dad in the renaming of this plaque here on this campus as Charles S. Garvin. You know, we consider him as a pioneer in education. He was a very smart man. He had a clear sense of things that were very important in life. Always God first, family, and respect, but education played a major role in his life. He was one that was determined to get things done, whether it be for that particular moment or for the future, because he was always thinking ahead. He expected the same from family and others, such as students that were under his leadership. And he definitely set an example for us. Even through his accomplishments in moving forward in his education and other set goals, he didn't let obstacles get in his way. He kept going and he never gave up. We believe if he were here today, he would say to the students here at Texas A&M Commerce, to the leadership, and each one of us in general, to keep pushing forward because we are of great value. Not just one, but all, and we can accomplish great things. My sister and I, we are so grateful, and we hope our dad's legacy will not just stop here, but it will make a difference in other lives. We hope that others will also be encouraged, that they will excel and make a difference in their own lives and other lives around them. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I am your commercial for the time being while Cedric and Dwight make it over to the unveiling. I'm Darrell Peace, the alumni director at the university, and I'm happy to be a part of this. Over the past year, maybe, I've had the opportunity to meet and dialogue with Renee and with Pamela, and it's just been a simple joy to do that. So it's like, right now it's like the time where you're on a game show, as we wait on them. Well, thank you guys for coming out. Somebody asked me earlier, kind of tell you there's those 6 degrees of separation. Ernest Taylor, I'm going to pick on you because somebody earlier said, you and Bubba Taylor are fraternity brothers. I said, no, we're just brothers. As you know, I'm a member of Alpha Phi Alpha, and Ernest is a member of Omega Psi Phi, my friend. Okay, I think the son-in-laws are over there, so we're going to count down. 3, 2, 1. Honored to be a part of this today. I am supposed to give closing remarks for my remarks that the wind just took them away. I am a fairly passionate and emotional person, and so on today, rather than trying to wing it and talk from my heart, I'm going to talk from a piece of paper that I actually wrote. So it's my pleasure to make closing remarks on today's festive and commemorative occasion. I assure you that there's nothing that I can add that will elevate the splendor of this day. Today I stand taller because I stand on the shoulders of Charles S. Garland, who was surely an unintended pioneer at East Texas State University. Mr. Garland was a consummate educator and a life learner. Use your imagination and let's walk in his shoes for a brief moment. Ask yourself these questions. Was he brave? Was he undaunted by challenges that he could and likely face as the only person of color at the university in 1964? Did he have a quest for knowledge that defied his circumstance? Did he have an idea that he would even leave a legacy this big? In the realm of space and time, we only have a minute. There is a educator, Dr. Benjamin E. Mays. He's an educator, a Baptist minister, the sixth president of Morehouse College, a member of Omega Psi Phi, who taught Martin Luther King, who was a member of Alpha Phi Alpha. And so he talks about a minute and how it's fleeting. And the poem goes, I have only just 1 minute, only 60 seconds in it, forced upon me, can't refuse it, couldn't choose it. But it's up to me to use it. I must suffer if I lose it, give account if I abuse it. Just a tiny little minute, but eternity is in it. There's eternity in everything that we do. Charles Garvin had no idea that this day would come. I think he is looking down from heaven on us, and I feel his spirit in this place. So today, I thank you for your attendance, your love, for sharing Charles Garvin with us, and I'll end it with that. The sun is coming out, and so here's an opportunity for you guys to take photos if you'd like by the sign, and then we will shuttle you over to the Student Center for lunch. Thank you so much.